We don't like to think about being unable to care for ourselves, but it could happen. When it comes to making decisions around your financial situation or your health care, it's better to have a plan in place before it's too late. I have received a number of questions very similar to Steve's email, and he asks, can you explain how a power of attorney works and why I would put one in place? My children are encouraging me to look into this, and I'm not sure if it's for me. Well, to help answer that question, here is attorney Barry Fish of Fish & Associates, and he's also the author of Where There's an Inheritance. Thank you so much for joining us.
Pleasure to be here, Patty.
Before we answer how do we put a power of attorney in place, what is a power of attorney?
It's authority for someone to do something for you, whether or not you can do it yourself.
All right. So you may be willing or unable to do something. What does that mean? Like, what does it cover?
Let me start off by expressing what happens if you don't have one. And we'll use Ontario as an example. In Ontario, without a power of attorney, the public guardian and trustee, when notified of incapacity, steps in and manages the affairs of the person who's incapacitated. If what you want is a loving, trusting person to do it and not have the government to do it, then you must have a financial power of attorney.
Now, at what stage in your life do you then put a financial power of attorney in place?
Whenever you have assets. In other words, imagine a 30-year-old or even a 28-year-old, and he feels or she feels that, it's not a rush. What happens if you get hit in the temple by a hockey puck and you wind up in the triage at a hospital and you don't know what day it is? Mm-hmm. And 2 days later, you still don't know what day it is. All of a sudden, there's notification to the government, and the same problem we just talked about takes place all over again.
Do you think people don't do it because of the cost, or they just simply think something's not going to happen to them?
Patty, very often we say that this is the cabbage that fell off the truck, meaning that a couple will go into a lawyer to do wills,
right,
and yet not get into the subject of power of attorney for some reason. And in our firm, we're very conscious of this, because a will is only effective if you die. It has zero effect while you're still alive. It's a power of attorney that gives this authority
to someone to step in and manage your affairs for you. What does it include? What can they manage on your behalf?
The first fork in the road is, let's distinguish between a medical and a financial power of attorney.
Okay.
On the medical side, essentially, it's path of treatment. It's the right, of course, to discontinue treatment if there's heroic measures, issues involved. And there's lifestyle issues as well on the medical side. On the financial side, what's very important is to have someone that you fully and absolutely trust. And that leads to another fork in the road, because the next question would be, when does it come into effect?
Mm-hmm.
And this is a very critical question.
So when does it?
Well, let me again talk in terms of fork in the road. Some people think that they want it to come into effect only if they're found to be mentally incapable. And the rationalization is, well, I don't want anybody to use it if I could still use it. But the reality is, if you have someone with whom you have a loving, trusting relationship, such as a spouse,
sure,
you don't want to clip their wings. And let me tell you what happens if you try that. This power of attorney shall only be effective if I'm found to be mentally incapacitated. Suppose we have that clause.
Mm-hmm.
And by the way, we're not recommending that when you have a trusting relationship, but suppose you do.
Mm-hmm.
And the person that you've named, who you love and trust, is duty-bound to help you. What happens if you have a 70-year-old who lost his wife, and now a gold-digging woman is trying to manipulate him, and a daughter who has the power of attorney is trying to block it? And she's got to show that the power of attorney is coming into effect, and she can't until she gets the doctor, and she's desperate to get that opinion. What happens if he can't give the opinion?
Yeah.
What happens if he qualifies the opinion? She's not able to help him.
There are too many restrictions put in place that just prohibit the whole thing from happening the way it should.
Exactly.
Now, is there anything that a power of attorney will not allow you to do?
It will not allow you to make a will. And people had better realize that, because you name somebody, they cannot make your will, and because of that, they can't make any testamentary dispositions. What if you have an RRSP or a RIF,
mm-hmm,
and you want to designate a beneficiary on it? Is that a testamentary disposition? I would not want to rely upon a power of attorney for that.
So basically, to sort of wrap it up, your rallying cry is when you go in and get a will, you should also get this power of attorney or directive for both your finances and your health,
exactly.
Done at the same time.
Exactly.
And can you ever revoke it? Can you ever say, okay, I don't want this in place because I don't trust you as much anymore?
As long as you have capacity, you can revoke it. And don't appoint somebody if you don't fully trust them, period.
Is that the bottom line? And
that's
how much does it cost? How much does it cost to get it done?
Well, if it's through a solicitor, it would be about $115 to $150. Prepackaged, it's a little bit less expensive. It depends upon the variables.
And what you put into it.
Exactly.
What you want into it. So what you're really saying is it's a pretty small cost for a pretty big peace of mind.
Yes, and remember, unlike a will, when you're gone, with a power of attorney, you're still here.
Right.
And if you need the help and you've lost your capacity, you're not catatonic staring at a ceiling. You're still reading comics. You're still laughing at shows. And you had better have somebody be able to give the directive to make your life comfortable for you.
That's what it's all about, Barry. Thank you so much.
My
pleasure.
Thank you
for joining us.
Thank you.